Grand Challenge program, Scholars Program, is a program launched at Duke in 2009 when we hosted the first Grand Challenges Summit for the National Academy of Engineering. And it's now being developed at 65 other universities around the country. And the vision for this program is to prepare a group of students, 20 per school from these 65 schools. So this will be 10,000 students over the course of a decade with a unique motivation and skill set to change the world. And so the thought is, if 300 Spartans could save a civilization in ancient Greece, just think what 10,000 motivated and specially skilled engineers can do for our society. And so Mona is chosen to take on that program, which is one of our most rigorous. So Mona, your project for the Grand Challenge Scholars is in Uganda. Can you tell us a little bit about how you got started on that program, what drew you to it, and what you're doing there?
In this picture, this is the last summer that I went back to Uganda, and so I was testing the quality of the water in the area, and so I'm at a shallow well, which was only like 3 to 5 feet deep, and so the water was very, very murky, and I was testing several places around Kaihara that looked like this. I also tested a rain harvest tank. I also tested a pipe, and I also tested their actual running water source, and just to see what the different types had and what kind of bacteria was in the water.
So there were a range of engineering technologies that you were generating as possible options. Did you end up choosing one that was best for this village and their needs?
Right, so I was looking mostly at point-of-use water treatment devices, which basically just means you can treat it not in a centralized location, which is very helpful for places like this where the infrastructure really isn't there yet.
Right.
And so I decided to choose ceramic water filters, which are basically like clay pots with silver nanoparticles painted around it. And that, to me, seemed like the best way to go for these.
Okay. And the silver nanoparticles contribute to sterilizing the water, and the ceramic contributes to the filtration, is that?
Right, so the water filtrates through the ceramic, which captures the bacteria in the pores, and then any other protozoa that like goes through the filter will then be killed or like deactivated by the silver.
Sounds pretty advanced and high tech. Is it affordable for people in Uganda?
Yes, so the point is that it's actually not very high tech at all. It's actually been proven to work well in other places like Singapore and in South Africa and other places in Uganda. And so it's affordable, maybe like $2 to $5 for a pot, and for a family that could be a lot, but then they last to up to 5 years, and so that actually decreases the.
So in order for the solution to be successful, so there's the technology piece and the affordability piece, but will people use it?
Yes, so that's definitely one of the other considerations that I had to choose in choosing different technologies, because culture is a very important aspect of it. Other technologies I looked at included biosand filtration, also chlorine tablets, and what I found in my research was that chlorine tablets generally aren't successful because people will stop using them because they make the water taste bad. And biosand filtration devices have too much of a upfront cost, and they're very big and bulky. And also people, once they learn how to use it, they can use it, but then there's a lot of people who are very adverse to the technology because they just think this looks really weird. Whereas right now they carry water in jerry cans, and so switching from a jerry can to a ceramic pot doesn't really look that different.
Very good, very interesting, and a nice example of how the solution goes beyond the technology alone.